NordPass versus Proton Pass. Two very similar password managers, both big names in the cybersecurity industry. But which one is ultimately better? It is time to pitch these two against each other. Now, I'll be honest with you. Personally, I use NordPass as a password manager, but I really like Proton as a company. So I'll be as unbiased as I can in this best password manager comparison. And when I say best, I mean it. These two set very solid examples. Not only are they both backed by widely known and trusted cybersecurity companies, they also follow top-tier security standards. There's zero knowledge architecture in place, along with strong encryption algorithms. This ensures that only scrambled, unreadable data is stored in the cloud, and nobody but you has access to it. The two password managers even went through multiple audits to prove this. These are the main reasons why I chose to do a NordPass versus Proton Pass comparison. Well, and the fact that they don't lack additional security features either, from biometric authentications and 2FA to data breach scanners. So if you just want a reliable password manager, you can pretty much pick either one of these, and I am sure they won't disappoint. And by the way, if you want to get a significant discount for these password managers, check the video description or scan one of these QR codes. But we're here to see which password manager app is better. And if you look hard enough, which I did, you can see differences even in the security front. For starters, NordPass uses slightly more modern encryption, XCHA-CHA20 instead of the standard AES-256-bit. While both are equally safe, XCHA-CHA is a little bit faster on some devices and easier to implement, therefore less prone to human error. Plus, I really like that NordPass offers an emergency access feature. With it, you can grant access to your vault to another NordPass user, whether it's a family member or a friend. If anything happens to you, they'll be able to request access to your account and securely receive passwords without having to know your master password. This feature is apparently coming to Proton Pass soon, but Proton has their own set of impressive features. Perhaps the coolest thing is that this password manager is completely open source, like all Proton products, so anyone can check the way this password manager handles security and privacy, and the community is very involved in helping to find and patch any vulnerabilities. Proton also offers an authenticator, while NordPass only has this feature available for business users. There are more differences in terms of features, but before we dive into that, I want to cover something I think is as essential. The basic functionality of both password managers. Each of them are pretty similar in this case. It's easy to add new logins with both, and storage isn't limited to passwords. I was able to store my credit card details, documents, and notes with file attachments. Both password managers offer password generators that come up with secure logins, and each also had a password monitoring tool. It points out old, reused, and weak passwords, but also alerts about breached accounts related to your email. I also didn't have any issues with autofill and autosave when testing out the providers. Both require an extension to be able to do this on a computer. As I mentioned, I mainly use NordPass myself, and I pretty much defaulted to using the NordPass Chrome extension at all times. It's just convenient. On mobile, no matter which password manager you opt for, the suggested login items appear above the keyboard, and you just need to click there to autofill the login field. Also, both password managers support passkeys, the new and more secure passwordless way to log in. I recommend checking out which one of your accounts support passkeys and replacing the regular logins. Fewer passwords means fewer chances for password leaks and safer accounts. The only difference here is that NordPass has passkeys on all of their apps, including desktop, while Proton Pass passkey support is limited to their browser extension and mobiles. Since we're going back to differences, you should know that the password manager option also offers email masking, an ability to generate fake email addresses to use online in order to keep your real email address safe. However, Proton Pass uses an integration with Simple Login for that, which is also a Proton product. And it has one major upside compared to NordPass. You can use your own custom domain, and the emails can be forwarded to several mailboxes. Plus, you can send emails from the alias and not just receive them to your primary email like with NordPass. Another difference is that while NordPass gives you up to 3 GB of secured storage, Proton Pass gives you 10 GB. So if you have a lot of sensitive documents, Proton is a bit more suited for that. Yet what I noticed is that these cool additional Proton features come at a cost, literally. NordPass is a much more affordable password manager, especially considering that you get it for 2 years, while Proton only has a yearly subscription. That said, the price is a bit better if you grab a discount from the description or through this Proton QR code. But the same thing applies to NordPass too. You can make their price even more wallet friendly through this QR code. Both password managers also have family subscriptions, but again, NordPass family plan is more affordable in this case as well. Even though both password managers have very similar benefits and you can share the family subscription with up to 6 users each. Another upside to NordPass is it's a bit more beginner friendly. Proton product interfaces tend to give off basement hacker vibes, so naturally it seems a bit more fitting for already tech savvy users. Maybe it's less of a case in terms of Proton Pass than with other Proton apps, but you can be the judge of that. What's nice is in the case of both NordPass and Proton Pass, the apps are pretty consistent across devices, no matter if you use a password manager on mobile, PC, a Mac, or browser extension. I can compliment NordPass for having categories for different items from the get-go, but you can create vaults to organize your stuff however you want with both password managers. Having said that, I have to give props to Proton Password Manager for letting me share an entire vault with their family plan instead of just singular items. This is honestly the feature I miss most in NordPass. Another thing where Proton stands out a bit is the fact that you need only one login for all Proton accounts. So if you have multiple Proton products, it's very seamless. I feel a bit uneasy about this though. Having all your eggs in one basket in terms of cybersecurity is already a bit of a risk, but only a single password to protect them all. Personally, I'd rather take a bit of inconvenience for more security. Of course, you can just add two-factor authentication to circumvent this, but we're not here to talk about my preferences. I'm here to help you pick the best password manager for you. So to sum up this whole NordPass versus Proton Pass comparison, here's a quick breakdown. If you're a beginner and want a more affordable password manager, go with NordPass. It's as seamless as it can get, with easy access to features. But if you're a bit more tech savvy and don't mind a higher price tag, try Proton Pass. It's open source and has great integration with other Proton products too. Whichever one is your ultimate choice, don't forget to claim the discount from the description, and then tell me about your experience with these password managers in the comments. You might help another person make a choice. Oh, don't forget to subscribe. Cheers.